It's the report which sets out the developments in establishing the Fairness and Social Justice Advisory Board, or say FASJAL, which was one of the priorities that was set out in the 100-day plan. I'm pleased to confirm that Lynn Collins has agreed to be the chair of the board, which will also ensure that fairness issues and social justice are considered within the decision-making and policy development process of the combined authority. Unfortunately, Lynn can't be with us today, but she's very much looking forward to starting that work. We believe that the board will comprise of between 12 and 14 members, and the membership will be confirmed in the new year when the advisory board hopefully has its first meeting. Are there any questions on Fairness and Social Justice Advisory Board? Yeah,
thanks, Jay. Yeah, I think this builds on the way that we've, as all of our local authorities, the majority of us have done fairness commissions and see a business case as well as an environment case for doing social value. It's at the heart of absolutely everything we do. And of course, we've all had our Fair City policies going forward. Obviously, we presented to government the Getting By in the Life of Fair Working Families, and then we presented to the Parliamentary Group on Poverty. We were the first to welfare reform the cumulative impact, which went to the Parliamentary Group on Hunger. And we're currently running with our citywide strategy for fairness and tackling poverty, the Social Value Task Group, and the Fairness and Tackling Poverty Task Group. And I think there's just so much talent and knowledge that's already out there that they will be able to harness going forward to make sure that we're all working together on this and build on the work that as councils we've already done.
Any other questions? Yeah.
Maybe an observation I started this week, I'm going to Liverpool City meeting to have a positive the Life Chances Commission meeting with Frank Field shortly after that. I mean, might be an idea of being invited Frank to comment on his work this week.
Anything else? On the Frank Field Chair Poverty groups where that will hopefully be very much feeding into the Fairness and Social Justice Advisory Board, and Councillor Ben's right that there are similar sorts of organisations or bodies that have been set up previously. This is a unique one in as much as it's the first for the combined authority, of course, but also it's a parent body, so it's not just sitting doing a piece of work, it will be there as long as we're there. And Lynn Collins has confirmed that one of her first jobs as the chair will be to look at the stuff that Liverpool did and all the reports that came onto that, but also I've visited Islington and they also, I think they were the first, probably with Liverpool, one of the first in the whole country to have a body, which is a commission that looked at fairness and social justice. This is inherent now to this body, and that's, I think, probably the difference, because these are the things that have done the work and finished. This will go on. Can we agree the recommendations on page 73? Item 10 is question time. We've received a number of questions. I think there's only one person who's here to ask their question, and that's Fiona Armstrong Gibbs. Is that right?
Yes.
Why is it that the Constitution can't be changed when it would deliver benefits to women and equality, but it can be changed to enable meetings to run more smoothly for yourselves?
Thanks, Fiona. Jill?
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. A number of other questions were submitted by Erica Rushton, Joe Anderson, Paula Nolan, members of the public. I believe they've been circulated around the chamber, and those will be answered within the usual time scales tonight.
So, Fiona, you will get a written response within 10 working days. Thanks for that.
Just clarify that it's Ms. Jill Anderson.
Okay, yeah. item 11, which is petitions and statements, and we have received either statements or petition. So we're on to item 12, which is the minutes of the Transport Committee, which is held on 7th of November. Can we confirm the minutes set up on page 83 to 92? Great, sorry. We agreed before I've even asked the question. Informed of any changes items, as this is, as I say, the last meeting before Christmas, may I take the opportunity to wish everybody Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. And the next meeting of the Combined Authority will take place on Friday, the 19th of January 2018, with APCO at 1 o'clock here in the Authority Chamber. Thanks for your attendance, and I will declare the meeting now closed.